Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the gray code. So we will see the importance of this gray code and we will also see some of the applications of this gray code. And then after, we will see the binary to gray code and the gray code to binary conversion. Alright, so this is how the decimal digit 0 to 15 can be represented in the 4-bit gray code. So this gray code is a non-weighted code. That means it does not follow the position weighting principle. So in the previous video, we have already seen some of the weighted codes. For example, this 8421 BCD code is the weighted code. But this gray code is the non-weighted code. Moreover, this gray code is also cyclic code. It means that if you see any two successive gray codes, then they differ only by a one digit. Therefore, this gray code is also known as the unit distance code. So the question is, what is the use of this gray code and where this gray code is used? And to understand that, let us compare this 4-bit gray code with the 4-bit binary numbers. Now in case of the binary number, when we move from one number to the next number, then sometimes the multiple bits are changing at the same time. For example, when we move from the binary number 3 to the binary number 4, then the 3 bits are changing at the same time. Similarly, when we move from the binary number 7 to the 8, then in fact, all the bits are changing at the same time. But on the other end, since the gray code is a unit distance code, so when we move from the one code to the next code, then only one bit is changing at the same time. And this is particularly useful in the position encoders. So these position encoders are used to track the linear or the angular position of the objects. So let us take the example of the linear position encoder. So let's say we want to track the position of some object. So to track the position of the object, the entire position range is divided into the 8 zones. And here, each zone is binary coded. That means using the 3 bits, we can define these 8 zones, right? And the presence of the object in this particular zone is detected using the position sensor. So here, the 3 position sensor A, B and C represents the 3 bits and effectively, they are representing the 8 zones. Now initially, let's say the object is in the 0th zone and correspondingly, the output of the sensor is equal to 000. Now whenever the object moves from the zone 0 to the zone 1, then the output of the sensor will change to the 001. So as you can see, there is a change only in the 1 bit. That means only the output of the sensor C is changing. And this output of the sensor will be read by the reader. So typically, this reader is also some digital circuit. Now let us take the second case, where the object is moving from the zone 1 to the zone 2. Now in that case, the output of the sensor B and C will change at the same time. Now typically, all these sensors are not identical and hence, it is quite possible that the one sensor reacts little later than the other one. So let's say, a sensor B reacts a little later than the sensor C, then for a moment, the output will become 000. And if the reader reads at the same time, then it will interpret that reading as if the object is moved from the zone 1 to the zone 0. Similarly, if the sensor C is little slower than the sensor B, in that case, momentarily, the output will become 011. And during this transition, if the reader reads this sensor, then it will interpret the data as if the object is moved from the zone 1 to the zone 3. So this glitch during the transition will lead to the position error. And it will even more prominent when the object is moved from the zone 3 to the zone 4. Because in that case, all the 3 bits or all the 3 sensors are changing simultaneously. So if the sensor B and C are little slower than the sensor A, then momentarily, the output will become 111, which actually represents zone 7. And if the reader reads the output of the sensor at that particular time, then it will interpret the data as if the object has moved from the zone 3 to the zone 7. So in that case, the position error will be significant. But this position error can be minimized if all the zones are coded using the gray code. So if all the zones are gray coded, then whenever the object is moving from the zone 3 to the zone 4, then only one bit is changing or only one sensor is switching. And that is why the position error will be minimum. So that is the biggest advantage of this gray code. And similarly, it is also used in the rotary encoder for the measurement of the angular position. So apart from that, this gray code is also used in the digital communication to reduce the errors. So during the processing, often it is required to convert this gray code into the binary, and similarly, sometimes the binary number also requires to convert into the gray code. So first of all, let us see the binary to gray code conversion. So here, the 4-bit binary numbers and the corresponding gray codes are shown side by side. So let's say we want to convert this binary number 1010 into the equivalent gray code. So first of all, let us write down this binary number 1010. And for our convenience, let's say starting from the LSB, these bits are B0, B1, B2, and B3. And correspondingly, the gray code is G3, G2, G1, and G0. So if we perform the binary to gray code conversion, then this bit G3 will be same as the B3. That means the MSB of the gray code will be same as the MSB of the binary number. And in that case, it is equal to 1. So then if we move to the next bit, then this G2 is equal to the B3 XOR B2. So far, we haven't talked about the XOR operation. But in simple terms, if I say, then if both inputs are different, then the result of the XOR operation will be equal to 1. And if both bits are identical, in that case, the result of the XOR operation will be equal to 0. So in this case, this B3 is equal to 1 and the B2 is equal to 0. And here, since both bits are different, so the result of the XOR operation is equal to 1. That means here, the G2 will be equal to 1. Similarly, this G1 will be equal to the B2 XOR B1. So here, the B2 is 0 and the B1 is equal to 1. And once again, since the both bits are different, so the result will be equal to 1. That means the G1 is also equal to 1. Likewise, the G0 is equal to B1 XOR B0. So here, the B1 is equal to 1 and the B0 is equal to 0. Therefore, the output of the XOR operation is equal to 1. And therefore, this G0 is equal to 1. That means the equivalent gray code for the binary number 1010 is equal to 1111. Similarly, let us take another example. So let's say we want to find the gray code for the binary number 0100. So first of all, let us write down this binary number. So as we have seen, for the gray code, we will copy the MSB as it is. That means this G3 is equal to 0. Then if we move to the next bit, then this G2 is equal to the B3 XOR B2. So here, since both bits are different, so this G2 will be equal to 1. Then if we move to the next bit, then this G1 is equal to B2 XOR B1. So once again, since both bits are different, so the result is equal to 1. That means the G1 is equal to 1. Similarly, this G0 is equal to the B1 XOR B0. So here, since both bits B1 and B0 are equal, so the output will be equal to 0. That means the G0 is equal to 0. That means the equivalent gray code for the binary number 0100 is equal to 0110. So that is how we can perform the binary to gray code conversion. Similarly, now let us see the gray code to binary conversion. So let's say we want to convert the gray code 1110 into the equivalent binary number. And for that, first of all, let us write down this gray code. So here, this G3 represents the MSB, while the G0 represents the LSB. And let's say the equivalent binary code is equal to B3, B2, B1, and B0, where this B3 is the MSB, while the B0 is the LSB. So during this gray code to binary conversion, the MSB of the binary number is same as the MSB of the gray code. That means here, this B3 is same as the G3. And in this case, it is equal to 1. Then if we move to the next bit, then B2 is the XOR of this B3 and g2. So here this b3 is equal to 1 and this g2 is also equal to 1. That means if we perform the XOR operation of the two identical number, then it will be equal to 0. That means this b2 is equal to 0. Then after, if we move to the next bit, then this b1 is equal to b2 XOR g1. So here this b2 is equal to 0 while this g1 is equal to 1. And since both numbers are different, so the output of this XOR function will be equal to 1. Or we can say that this b1 will be equal to 1. Then after, if we move to the next bit, then this b0 can be given as b1 XOR g0. So as you can see, here the b1 is 1 while the g0 is equal to 0. So once again, since both inputs are different, so the output of this XOR function will be equal to 1. And therefore, this b0 will be equal to 1. That means the binary equivalent of the given gray code 1110 is equal to 1011. So that is how we can perform the gray to binary conversion. So let us take one more example. So let's say we want to find the binary equivalent of the gray code 0101. And for that, first of all, let us write down this gray code. So as we have seen, the MSB of the binary number is same as the MSB of the gray code. That means here, this B3 is equal to G3. Then if we move to the next bit, then this B2 is the XOR combination of this B3 and G2. So here, this B3 is equal to 0, while this G2 is equal to 1. And since both bits are different, so the output will be equal to 1. That means the B2 is equal to 1. Similarly, if we move to the next bit, then this B1 can be given as B2 XOR G1. So here, the B2 is 1, while the G1 is 0. And once again, since the both bits are different, so the output will be equal to 1. That means the B1 is equal to 1. Similarly, if we move to the next bit, then this B0 is the XOR combination of this B1 and G0. So here, both B1 and G0 are 1. And since both are same, so the output will be equal to 0. That means this B0 is equal to 0. That means if we see the overall binary number, then it is equal to 0110. So that is how we can find the equivalent binary number for the given gray code. So similarly, try to find the binary equivalent of the given gray codes and do let me know your answer in the comments. But I hope in this video, you understood about this gray code and you also understood how to perform the binary to gray code and the gray code to binary conversion. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.